next governor of Kansas will take office, facing a $400 million hole in the state budget. Compared to recent years, that's a much smaller gap. KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney reports on how Republican Sam Brownback and Democrat Tom Holland plan to deal with it.
Small, that the Kansas economy may be making a comeback.
But can it continue? This summer, the state increased its sales tax by 1%, and some worry that temporary three-year increase might slow this delicate recovery because it will cost about $300 million a year. So there were calls for repeal. Kansas Republican gubernatorial candidate Sam Brownback was asked in the summer if he supported repealing that sales tax if elected.
What we're going to do is to look at overall tax policy to get it in a position for us to be pro-growth. You have to be in a pro-growth position coming out of this recession, and we're going to examine the whole thing.
By the fall, in an interview with Channel 9, he said he would not try to repeal it.
Not initially. We're not going to look at repealing that, given the current balance of where the state budget is.
His Democratic opponent, State Senator Tom Holland, supports the three-year increase of 1%, but he will not take the possibility of additional revenue or fee increases off the table.
I'm not, but I'm hopefully we won't have to go there. We'll see how the economy acts the rest of this year going forward.
So how is Kansas doing? Well, tax collections are up slightly from a year ago at this time, but the stimulus money that Kansas used to pay for Medicare and for its schools is running out. So the state will have to fill that $400 million stimulus hole. And they can do that if the recovery continues. But nobody knows that for sure.
So it is very unlikely that there will be any repeal of the Kansas sales tax, no matter who gets elected governor. The new governor and the legislature will have to hope that the economy continues to recover just to stay even. Otherwise, the possibility of more cuts may be greeting the next governor of Kansas. Micheal Mahoney, KMBC 9 News. Back to you.
Micheal, thank you. The next set of projections on the Kansas economy comes out in about 3 weeks on Election Day, to be exact.